Welcome back to the Roadshow this morning. The buzz: could the nation's children be getting too fat to fight? Well, according to some officials, yes. Now listen to this. A group of retired military officers is giving lunch a new label, a national security threat. And that's not a reference to the mystery meat served up in the cafeteria line either. The retired officers are saying that school lunches have helped make the nation's young people so fat that fewer of them can meet the military's physical fitness standards, and recruitment is in jeopardy. So now they're proposing a wide-ranging nutrition bill that aims at making this nation's school lunches healthier. Take a look.
Nearly one-third of our children are either overweight or obese, and only one in four of today's 17 to 24-year-olds are able to enlist for military service due to a number of reasons, but predominantly because of lack of a high school diploma or obesity.
As youngsters learn more about the calories that are involved, as they learn more about the nutritional value, what's available to them, they're going to make the smart choice and the wise choice, especially if we reinforce that in schools. And when you combine this with physical activity, it's a winning combination.
Very interesting. What do you guys think?
Well, first off, I think the lunches in general should be healthy in general. It shouldn't have to do anything with, these guys are coming from a military
perspective.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So they're thinking these kids eat too much. You know, they're not going to be able to help defend the country if that's the line of work they want to get into. But, I think we should, the military shouldn't have had to come out and say this. People should be coming out saying, we need kids to be healthy in general. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It shouldn't have to wait on a general to come in and say, hey, fatso, put down the grilled cheese, pick up a rifle.
What do you think, Patrick?
Well, I think this goes beyond school lunches. I think it starts at home. With the kids at home. Unfortunately, there's a couple of things. It's caloric bribery is what I call it sometimes with some people that they either reward or try and get their kids away from them by giving them food.
Yeah, let's go for a happy meal if you get a great good grade on a test.
It's true, and that's the thing. The other thing, too, that I think is just killed children's physical fitness is computers, the DS games, all the stuff that have them inside. There's times where I literally have to push my kids out the door to go out and play. When I was a kid, my parents had to roam the neighborhood and try and find me to get me to come inside. Yeah. And you'll drive by empty ball fields, basketball courts, soccer fields nowadays, whereas before, we would have those places filled and we would play outside and therefore burn calories, exercise, and be in better shape.
Well, Jamie Oliver's, I love documentaries, and this is kind of in that vein. Jamie Oliver's Food Revolution. Jamie Oliver is the naked chef from the UK, and he came over here to do what he did in London, which was to revolutionize the food system in one particular school district in Huntington, West Virginia. And what's amazing to me is that he would make these foods and they would say, Jamie, you don't have enough vegetables. And he would look it over there and he would say, well, you guys, with your typical school lunch, I don't see enough vegetables either. And they would hold up a French fry and say, well, this is a vegetable. And he would do other things, like he would serve a rice as a starch and they would say, well, you need two starches, so you also have to serve a roll. And, it's just amazing to me the resistance to change. And it really is, I've heard people describe most of America's pantries as the white tomb of death, with the white flour, the white sugar, the processed foods. And it does lead to behavior problems in kids and being able to concentrate and that sort of thing. And even if you do it at home, if when you send them to school, they have no other choices to make.
Well, I just want to say this real quick, is that it's one thing to get to try and convince kids to eat healthy. It's not easy.
No.
But it's another thing to get them out of the house and exercise.
Yeah. Sure.
That's a lot.
It's only, first off, at school, it's only one meal a day of that day, and it's only 5 days a week, and they're not going to school 12 months a year.
Yeah.
And I think it starts at home, eating healthy. If you're serving healthy food at home, they're
going to
expanding their palate. Hopefully, they start looking for healthy foods at school. But not only that, I'm with him, man. I think I was the last generation.
Yeah.
There are basketball courts and baseball fields at
street
the end of my
hockey,
street
baseball,
that are
football,
empty,
you name it, we
empty
play
24
it.
Hours a day now. It's sad.
Well, I tell you what, Courtney, I am curious to hear what parents on our live blog are saying this morning.
We have some grandparents on the live blog that are sharing what they think, and this one is coming from Jean. She says, I can't give an opinion on this, and she's so out of the loop because she doesn't have kids in school now, but she can say that her grandkids do eat too much junk food. And Joseph Butera says, listen to Pat. He's a wise man, so he does agree with you, Patrick, in your stances on the school lunches. We have a poll here on foxprovidence.com. Are school lunches a threat? threat to national security. A, yes, kids are too fat to fight. B, they're only in part to blame. Or C, lunches don't impact military strength. So you can weigh in there if you're just joining us this morning, or of course on our Facebook page. We've been doing really well. Lots of comments here in the morning. This one's from Wendy Curtis, and she said, with 27% of eligible recruits already too fat to join up now, think of how bad it'll be in another 10 years. Yes, a sensible place to start is with the school lunch. Making healthy choices at a young age can last a lifetime. Lauren Silva says it's not the school lunches, it's the habits parents allow their children to get into, like eating unhealthy. If they eat unhealthy at home, they'll make, you know, the same choices at school. And Pamela Burkett says, definitely agrees, making healthy choices begins at home first. So that's where some of our parents stand right now, but we'll see what you all said on the poll at the end of the show. For now, we're going to head back to the kitchen. Patrick, what's happening?